click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in today's video, we are going to see what do you mean by analog signals and what do you mean by digital signal, their comparison, their applications, and analog and digital circuits. So let's begin with the topic. We know that the signals or the circuits which we have seen so far consist of the circuit which uses a signal called as analog signal. The analog signals are those signals which are continuously changing with respect to time. The example of such signals are nothing but sound, temperature, intensity of the light. So all these quantities varies continuously and smoothly with respect to time. Amplitude of these signals may have any value at any instant of time. So we can say we can represent that system by using a sine wave, and the representation is so from the diagram, we will come to know that the amplitude of the signal varies continuously with the time. It is not fixed at certain point. At any point of time, the amplitude can have any value. But the amplitude of the signal can be sampled in order to get a discrete value by using a process called as analog to digital converter. With the invention in the terms of computers or with the invention in the terms of digital circuits, the another signal that comes into picture that is nothing but digital signals. Digital signals are those signals which are obtained by sampling the analog signal at certain interval. So the digital signal is nothing but a set of discrete values of finite number. The digital signals are nothing but the binary system, and they are represented by using a square wave. The representation of the digital signal is given by as we can see, the digital signal having only two voltage level, that means 0 and 1, which is also called as logic 0 or logic 1. These two logic level are called as states of the signal, and they have certain value of voltage. The logic 0 is equal to 0 volt, whereas logic 1 is equals to 5 volt. The digital signals are used for implementation of the logic gates or digital circuits. Now the analog circuit basically consists of those signals which varies continuously with respect to time. Analog circuits can convert original signal into any form, for example digital form. In case of analog signal, the signal may get vary due to the introduction of noise or due to the introduction of distortion. But in case of digital signal, as they have only two states, that means 0 and 1, the effect of noise, the effect of distortion is very less as compared to analog signal. Now let's see the comparison between analog signals and digital signals. Now let's see the difference between analog signal and digital signals. The analog signal and digital signals can be compared on the basis of various parameters. So the first parameter is nothing but basic. Basic is nothing but the form in which the signal carries the information. So analog signal carries information in continuous variation of time, whereas digital signal carries information in discrete interval of time. So we can say analog signal varies continuously with respect to time, whereas digital signal having discrete values. Then the second point for the comparison is nothing but representation. The analog signals are usually represented in the form of sine wave, whereas digital signals are represented in binary form, that is, we can say in the form of square wave. Next point of comparison is nothing but description. The analog signal can be used to describe information in the form of or in terms of amplitude, frequency, and phase distortion, whereas digital signals are used to describe in terms of bit rate and bit interval. Now, the next point of comparison is nothing but range. The analog signal do not have any range. They have infinite range. Whereas the digital signal having finite range, that means between 0 and 1. So whatever changes are there are present in the digital signals, they can vary between the range of 0 to 1. So no finite range in case of analog signal and having finite range, which is between 0 and 1. Then the next parameter is nothing but effect of noise. The analog signals are get easily affected by noise, whereas digital signals are less prone to noise. The next parameter is the effect of distortion. Similar to noise, the analog signals are get easily affected by distortion, which may be a harmonic distortion, phase distortion, or frequency distortion. Whereas the digital signal, as they carry signal in terms of discrete values, therefore they are get less affected by distortion. Conversion process. The analog signal can be converted into digital signal by using A to D converter, that means analog to digital converter, whereas digital converter can be converted into analog signal by using analog to digital converter. So we can say to convert analog signal into digital, we require analog to digital converter. And to convert digital signal into analog, we require digital to analog converter. Now the next parameter is transmission, or the way in which the signal is get transmitted. So in case of analog signal, the data or the signal is get transmitted in the form of wave, whereas in case of digital signal, the data or signal is get transmitted in the form of binary zeros or one. Now the last parameter that we can use for comparison is nothing but example. The example of the analog signal includes temperature, human voice, then sound light intensity. These are the examples of analog signal, whereas the data which is transferred between the computer is considered as an example of digital signal. So this is about the comparison between analog signals and digital signals. The analog signal having many disadvantages, like they are more prone to noise, they are more prone to distortion, that it may possible that the information carried by analog signal may get changed during transmission. Whereas in case of digital signal, as they are get less affected by noise, therefore the information is get secured between transmission and reception. The another advantage of using digital signal is that the digital signals are very easy to detect for error correction and detection. They are also very easy for rectification purpose, which is very much difficult in case of analog signal. So this is about the comparison between analog and digital signals. Now moving towards the applications of digital signals, the digital signal having many applications in the area of communication. They having many applications in the industrial areas. They can be used to carry information over a longer distance. And nowadays, it is very much easy to recover the information if the information is stored in the digital form rather than in the analog form. So this is what about the analog signals, comparison between analog and digital signals, and applications of digital signal. So I hope you understand the topic. So thank you very much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ikeda. Subscribe Ikeda. Thank you.